वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमन्वितम् श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितम् श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजनो समायुक्तम् बिंदावनम् मनोहर वांछाकल्पतरुवश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यो च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपा तमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवम् वृंदावई तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशवश्च कृष्णभक्तिपदे देवी सत्त्वत्वयी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरे संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरीय पत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरु भक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरुण्यं देयं सदा परिभवग्नम् अविष्टदोहं तेथास्पदं शिव विरिञ्चनुतं शरण्यं भीतात्तिहं पुनदपाल भवाद्विभूतं वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दं यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्द्रमणिच्छटायि विस्फुरजित किमपि गोपवधूषुदर्शि पूर्णानुरागरससागर सारमूर्ति साराधिकामयि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्रीअद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदतु संकीर्तनैकवितरु कमलायुताक्षौ विश्वाम्बरौ द्विजवरौ युगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणावतारौ हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वन्दितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गङ्गातरङ्गरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषितवामभागम् नारायणो प्रियमनङ्गमदापहारं वरानुषिपुरपति भजवीशनाथं वागीशजस्वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ते संवित् त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम राम Krishna Kirtana Gana Nartana Kalapatho Jani Vajita Sadvakta Valihamsa Chakra Madhupo Seni Viharaspadam Karna Nandi Kaladhanir Bahatume Jivha Maru Prangani Sri Chaitanya Dayanidhe Tavalasad Lila Sudha Swarduni Krishna Kirtana Gana Nartana Paro Pemamritam Bhonidhi Dhiradhira Jana Priyo Piyo Karo Nirmasaro Pujito Sri Chaitanya Kipavaro Bhavibhavo Varavantaraku Bande Rupa Sanatano Sijivugo Drogujugo Sijivugo Palako Bande Rupa Sanatano Rogujugo Sijivugo Palako Gauriya Goshtipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. So, that any problem we are facing in our material life, in our daily life, it should be considered as a kippa of Supreme Lord. Any problem we are facing in our life, this should be treated as kippa of Supreme Lord. According to our previous karma fall, we are getting this. So all directly or indirectly, everything done by Supreme Lord. So any problem happening in your life, we should treat as, it should be treated as the kippa of Supreme Lord, nothing else. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, when our objective all the same, our purpose, objective, everything same, then there cannot be any infighting. If your ideology, if your idealism, if your goal, if your mood of service, everything same, then there cannot be any infighting among us. It's very painful. Gauriya Tathacharya, Vedanta Tathacharya actually, Srila Jiva Goswami Pad, his appearance day today. Actually, Vishwa Vishnava Rasava, total Vishwa Vishnava Rasava, were totally organized by Srila Jiva Goswami Pad perfectly. After Rupa Sanatan, they all gone. Jiva Goswami Pad took the responsibility of this Vishwa Vishnava Rasava. And under his guidance, there was almost no problem. Everyone, that time, they tried to do bhajan perfectly. Because at that time, there was no problem because all those devotees, that time, all Gosai Bhas, all, you know, Loknath Goswami, Bhogardev Goswami, Samananda Prabhu, everybody, who not, Srinivas Acharya, Samananda Prabhu, everybody, Narottama Thakur, all their goal, Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami Pad, all their target was all the same, to serve the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exclusive way, nothing else. All their desire is to serve the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exclusive way, that's why there was no problem. So, Prabhupada speaking, if there is same and idealism, same seva mood, no self-interest, nothing. So there cannot be any infighting among devotees. Or at all infighting sin, it is also very good because it is to do seva. I can do more seva. I can do more seva. I can do this seva. This way, if there is at all infighting, you can find that there is very exclusive, but it is very nice. It is actually, we can pay honor to this kind of infighting. Infighting this kind of fighting. It's very good. Actually, Srila Jiva Goswami Pad is a Gauriya Vedanta Tathacharya. Sarup Gosai, under the guidance of Sarup Gosai, Sarup Gosai, the all Gauriya, actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was bound to give the total responsibility to Sarup Gosai first. Sarup Gosai, Sarup Damodar. After that, a flow of, you know, Seva Mur, everything, Baba, everything coming. So under the guidance of Sarup Gosai, I told many times before, to understand the grade, to understand the quality of a Gauriya Bhakta, to understand the quality of a Gauriya Bhakta, what is the rank of that Bhakta, we must understand the Vichar, Siddhanta Vichar of Sarup Gosai. If we can understand Sarup Gosai, then we, very easily we can understand what is the situation of this present devotional field, what is the rank of that devotee, easily we can understand, very easily. Because actually, Sarup Gosai, our Gauriya Guru Varga, speaking, until and unless we are getting one certificate, until and unless we are going to get one tested certificate from Sarup Gosai, we cannot identify ourselves as Gauriya Acharya. Not possible. Until and unless we are going to get one certificate from Sarup Gosai, we cannot, you know, declare ourselves as Acharya, Gauriya Acharya. Not possible. And many times, I told, it is the Siddhanta Vichara Prabhupada, to give full protection to Siddhanta Vani is the only duty of Gauriya Acharya, Sampradayik Acharya. Sampradayik Acharya means to protect, give full protection to Sampradayik Vaibhav. Sampradayik Vaibhav, Vani Vaibhav. Sampradayik Vaibhav, protection. Sampradayik Sangrakhanayik Acharya. You can remember, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in front of Balwar Chajwa, I can come to this topic after some time. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu declared in front of Vallabhacharya that Siddhaswami Pad is Acharya. Though Siddhaswami is from Vishnu Swami Sampradaya, why Mahaprabhu wanted to speak this way? And why Mahaprabhu accepted Madhvacharya as our previous Acharya in our line? What can be the reason? So, all comparative statement of those four Sampradayik Acharyas, because four Sampradayik Acharyas, our four Sampradayik, Madhvacharya, Ramanujacharya, Nimbarkacharya, Vishnu Swami, they are all main pillar on the basis of which all the Vaishnav society, their darshan, everything resting, main pillar. Out of the four pillars, two pillars, actually, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Jiva Goswami Pad, actually, they wanted to declare, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also clearly declared Madhvacharya as Surya Acharya and Siddhaswami Pad as our Bhakti Rakshika Acharya, who is giving protection to Bhakti, devotional field, Bhakti line. Actually, Jiva Goswami Pad, from the very beginning, somebody is speaking that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disappeared, Jiva Goswami Pad appeared. But not that. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it cannot so happen. Because all data, I mean the different, you know, historical evidence, actually not going to prove this. On the contrary, we would say that when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disappeared, that time, Jiva Goswami Pad was almost 10 years of age. Anyway, we can give an indication from previous Acharyas, I mean Bhakti Ratnakar here, there are so many. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Ramkeli Gram, North Bengal, Ramkeli Gram, one there, they are Sanatan Roop, they used to stay there. There to do full kripa, to show full kripa on Rupa Sanatan, Mahaprabhu went there. In the way of his Vrindavan journey, Mahaprabhu went to Ramkelika, and from Ramkelika went to some place, Kanai Natsala, and from there Mahaprabhu came back. He couldn't go to Vrindavan. Some reason there, anyway. So, that time, we can get indication when Rup Sanatan, they came in very ordinary dress, came very secretly at a night time, midnight, to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Ramtaligam. That time actually, Jiva Goswami Pada was very small boy. He came to take darshan of the lotus feet of, you know, Mahaprabhu. It is, we are getting this kind of indication. Anyway, so after that, we all know that Rupa Goswami Pada already lived. Rupa Goswami Pada was finance minister of the king of Bengal that time. So Rupa Goswami Pada already gone to Vrindavan, that time already run for Vrindavan to meet with Prabhu. And Sanatan Goswami Pada was in jail somehow. It was so after that Sanatan Goswami Pada also gone. And in the meantime, you already know that the father of Srila Jiva Goswami Pada, Anupam, the younger brother of Rupa Sanatan, he was there with Rupa Goswami Pada in the way of Vrindavan, of coming back, in the way of his return. At the bank of Ganga, he lived body. I mean, Anupam lived body. Age was not so matured age, very small age anyway. After that, Jiva Goswami Pada was totally alone, feeling alone, and always crying and crying, how to get the lotus feet of Gauranga this way. And from very, very childhood, he is so intelligent, that even in small age, he completed Sanskrit Vyakaran, Chanda, everything, all, very, very quickly, complete, very. After that he was thinking, because father gone, everything, how to stay. He always tried to go to Vrinda and go to meet the Lord, see the lotus feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu all the time. This way always trying his best to leave the home. You know, after that somehow he took permission from home to get education from Navadip. This way he came to Navadip to take darshan of Navadip, everything. And that time, Sivas Prabhu, one day, Nityananda Prabhu was there, from Khorda came, and Sivas Pandit is speaking, that perhaps Jiva can come. In the meantime, Jiva Goswami is already there in gate. And Nityananda is speaking, Jiva is already there in gate, you bring him. Then they go outside and find Jiva crying. Jiva Goswami Pada is there in gate. They bring him in front of Nityananda Prabhu. And in front of Nityananda Prabhu, prostrate Dandavat, not only that, he cannot stand. So crying and crying like mad. After watching the lotus feet of Nityananda, because in dream, I forget to speak you, at home also in dream, when crying and crying, cannot stay, going to leave body. That time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, with Saparshat, full groups, Nityananda, I mean, you know, Gauranga, Nityananda, Advaita Gosai, you know, Sivas Pandit, other Pandit, all, full troops, in Sankirtan, Jiva Goswami Pada, in dream, saw, in dream. In dream, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, and giving assurance to Jiva Goswami Pada, don't think, you are going to get the lotus feet of Nityananda. I mean, Gauranga wanted to offer Jiva Goswami Pada to the lotus feet of Nityananda. Has some reason. Because Guru, na? Nityananda Prabhu's Guru, topmost, you know, original Guru Tata. So, Jiva Goswami Pada now coming here, Navadip. After that, he met Nityananda Prabhu or previous, or Sivas Pandit, etc. All, everybody there. And getting full kripa of Nityananda Prabhu. Nityananda Prabhu, out of his full, you know, love and affection, going to put the lotus feet, his lotus feet on the head of Jiva Goswami Pad to stop his crying, you know. After that, Nityananda Babu took Jiva Goswami Pad with him to travel all, you know, parikram of Gaur Dham parikrama. Now, Jiva Goswami Pad got a chance to do Dham parikram, Navadip Dham parikram, under the guidance of Nityananda, original Guru Tattva. Guru Tattva is always secret. Guru Tattva is always secret, that's why the name of Radharani you cannot find in Bhagavatam. You cannot find any, you know, thing, topics in Hari Bhakti Bilaya about, you know, Baladeva, all secret thing. Guru Tattva is so secret, is common people, they cannot understand. What is Guru Tattva? So when you can remember, before I told that when our Jagadananda Pandit repeatedly wanted to take permission from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, please give me permission. I like to go and take darshan of Jagadip Vrindavan Dham. Mahaprabhu not going to give permission, repeatedly in asking for permission, ultimately. You know, Swarupa Gosai, Rai Ramananda, you know, they are requesting, you know, to allow Mahaprabhu, please you allow him, he like to take darshan after that he gone. But one advice I like to give you, reminder, Mahaprabhu was bound to speak that you are going to Vrindavan, but you cannot stay there for long. Vrindavani jayo, you are going to Vrindavan, but you cannot stay there for long. You are going to Vrindavan, but don't stay there for long. And whenever you are going to Vrindavan, all the time, every time you have to stay under the guidance of Sanatana Gosai. Mahaprabhu giving one vital instruction that when you are going to Vrindavan, every fraction of second you will have to stay with Sanatana Gosai. Don't leave with Sanatan. You have to stay with Sanatan. Why? Sanatan Goswami Pad is Sammandha Tattva Acharya, Sammandha Gena Acharya. So without any sense of relationship, we cannot develop any seva for Supreme Lord. We cannot develop any mood to do service of Dham, Nam, anything. Even Prabhupada speaking this way, which is very typical, you know, even Pope was speaking this way, until and unless you cannot understand that your Guru Padma, Sadguru Padma, not Asadguru Padma. Pope was speaking, until and unless you cannot feel that your Guru Padma is non-different from Supreme Lord. If you cannot feel this point, then never you can do Harinam properly. Follow what I say. When you can, if you cannot feel that Supreme Lord, my Guru Padma is non-different from Supreme Lord. If you cannot understand this point, till then, you cannot do Harinam. Harinam cannot come to dance in your tongue, on your tongue, not possible. So, Jiva Goswami, actually, Mahaprabhu giving instruction to Jagadananda Pandit, you can go to Vrindavan, but each and every fraction of second you have to stay all the time. You have to stay under the guidance of, you know, Sanatana. All the time. Because Sanatana Goswami is Sammandagana Acharya, Mahaprabhu wanted to give us indication. And here, in whole parikram, Gaurdham parikram, actually, Srila Jiva Goswami Pad following Nityananda, and Nityananda Babu going to indicate this is Leela, this is the place here, Gauranga Mahaprabhu doing this Leela, all, you know, Gaurdham parikram. After that, after parikrama is over, after And after that, actually, Jiva Goswami also took the darshan of the lotus feet, you know, Jarnava Thakurani, I can come to these topics, also took the opportunity to take the darshan of, this Vishnupriya Devi, Ishan Thakur, that time, actually. So, actually, Swachima, that actually Jiva Goswami Pad, Jiva Goswami Pad, actually, after doing parikram, Gaurdham parikram, after that, Nityananda Prabhu giving instruction to Jivapad, you can go to Varanasi. Nityananda Prabhu giving instruction to Jivapad, in the way of your Vrindavan, you will have to go to Vrindavan, Prabhu, Mahaprabhu giving place to Sanatan, Rup, all you. Your place is there in Vrindavan, Mahaprabhu already giving seva to you all. So you must go to Vrindavan, but in the way of Vrindavan, you will have to go to Varanasi. Why? Because Varanasi, Nityananda Prabhu wanted to send him, because Jiva Goswami Pad is exclusive. He is so fine vichar, so fine intellect, aprakita. So Nityananda Prabhu wanted to send him to Varanasi. There under the guidance of, Madhusudan Vachaspati. Who is Madhusudan Vachaspati? Actually, Madhusudan Vachaspati is a disciple of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was Mayavadi previously. He was manifesting this kind of lila. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya manifesting this kind of lila. He was Mayavadi. After that, by the mercy of Gopinath Acharya, and by the mercy of Gaurangama, ultimately by the mercy of Gauranga Mahaprabhu and all devotees, he got Shuddha Bhakti. So, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, when wanted to give, you can remember, when Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya wanted to give Vedanta Bhaksha, he wanted to explain Vedanta in front of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Because Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is speaking, you are too young to maintain sannyas actually. So it is good that you can hear Vedanta from me all the time to protect your renounce order, So this way, when speaking, Mahaprabhu very humbly, okay, you are actually going to give me kippa, I must obey you. And after that started hearing Vedanta in front of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, I can explain it someday, detailed discussion. Already translation, I already published 10-12 years back, Nilachale Vedanta Vyakhya, Hindi already published, Bengali already published, English translation already done, editing going on, you can go through, it's an exclusive book, very nice book. Where you can get all detailed discussion of Vedanta discourse between Mahaprabhu and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. So first of all, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya wanted to give teachings on Vedanta to Mahaprabhu. After that something happened, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was bound to take shelter unto the lotus feet of Mahaprabhu after knowing all Bhakti Siddhanta. He was out of danger by that time. So now we get indication from our previous Acharya and from Bhakti Ratnakar here there that this Madhusudan Vachaspati is a highly learned man, very, very big Pandit, very big, famous in Varanasi, very famous. But when Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya could realize that Gauriya Vedanta, first of all Mayavad Vedanta, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya wanted to explain in front of Mahaprabhu. But ultimately, when Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya could realize, this is called actually Gauriya Siddhanta and Vedanta. Gauriya Siddhanta. Gauriya Vedanta Acharya Jiva Goswami Pad. So I am coming to this point. So, After getting this kind of exclusive kipa from Mahaprabhu, after getting Gaudiya Vedanta Acharya Darshan, Sarvam Bhattacharya was very impressed. After that, Sarvam Bhattacharya was bound to give this knowledge to Madhusudan Vachaspati to preach this Gaudiya Siddhanta, Gaudiya Vedanta Siddhanta. So Sarvam Bhattacharya was bound to give this Gaudiya Vedanta Siddhanta to Madhusudan Vachaspati. That's why Nityananda Babu wanted to send him there. So Madhusudan Vachaspati going to give lesson, day by day. But Madhusudan Vachaspati was so impressed. He was so impressed to see the fine intellect of Jiva Gosvami. Vidyaval, so educational power of this small boy. He was just impressed to see. So he wanted to give all education within short time. Jiva Goswami Pad took all lesson there, Gaudiya Vedanta Darshan, everything, and from there on also Vedanta, so many things, After that, Jiva Goswami Pad took permission from Srila Madhusudan Vachaspati, to go to Vrindavan. So when Jiva Goswami Pad ultimately reaching Vrindavan, and from then onward, up to the last moment of his life, he never wanted to leave Vrindavan. It is called Vrindavan Ashray. Actually, we are so foolish, we don't understand by this word shelter. We take this word casual. I have taken shelter of Gurudev. Really, you have taken shelter of Gurudev? You know the meaning of shelter? Shelter, you know the meaning of shelter? Shelter means any problem going to happen in your life, you are not going to leave the lotus feet of Gurudev. It is called Gurupath Ashray. So we casually using this word, I have taken shelter of Gurudev, but it is not actually shelter. To take shelter under the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava means, If I am going to die, some critical position coming in my life, I am going to die. Still at that moment, I am not going to leave the lotus feet of Guru Padma. It is called Guru Padasraya. Adau Guru Padasraya Tasmat Krishna Adi Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. So we are always going to take this word casually. Ashray loiya bhaje tari Krishna nahi teje ar sab mori akaran. Chaitanya Bhagavat, Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya speaking. Ashray loiya bhaje, those who are really going to take shelter of Sadguru Vishnu, those who are really going to take shelter of Nam Prabhu, those who are going to take shelter of Dhamma, no problem can touch them. All bhajan, they can realize what is bhajan, everything, because they are taking shelter. Genuinely, from heart, they are going to take shelter of Dham, Nam, Guru, Guru, Dham, Nam, everything. So, to take shelter unto a lotus feet of Dham, Nam, and to take shelter of Guru Path is very important issue. So, Vrindavan Das Thakur, that's why speaking, those who are not going to take shelter of Guru Vaishnava, we cannot take their responsibility. Because anyway, they are going to die. Who is going to control their life? They are leading their life recklessly. Like, brakeless car. If a car in which you are sitting, if you find it is brakeless, the brakeless car means anywhere you can collide, accident can happen. So, bonded soul, their life they are leading, but they are driving their life recklessly, because they have no controlling over their sense organ, minds, nothing. That's why their life is in danger. So bonded soul anyhow going to follow their own mind as their director. They are not going to follow Guru Vishnu properly. That is the main problem. So if they are not going to follow pure Guru Vaishnava, how, who can control them? Who can get control over their character, behavior, how to get control? So you see, like a brakeless car, they are going to die. So Vrindavan Das Thakur Maharaj is giving guarantee that Ashray Loiya Bhaje Tare Krishna Nahi Taje. Those who are going to take shelter genuinely, without any duplicity, those who are going to take shelter of pure Guru Vaishnava, Ashray Loiya Bhaje Tare Krishna Nahi Taje. Krishna never going to leave them. Arsab Mariyaka and the rest, all going to die without any cause. There is no meaning of their life. So Ashray Loiya Bhaje Tare Krishna Nahi Taje, Arsab Mari Akaran. They are going to die. And Prabhupada giving guarantee, those who are genuinely taking shelter unto lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, Sadguru, those who are going to do Guru Seva from heart, without any duplicity, from genuinely, they are going to Guru Seva, like Jiva Goswami Pada. I can give you example. Through Guru Seva, be careful. Through Sadguru Seva, surely they can get Tattva-gyan. Tattva-gyan get mean not only memorize, get realization of Tattva-gyan. And Prabhupada giving guarantee, those who are going to take shelter of Sadguru, those who are going to do Seva tirelessly, without any, you know, non-stop Guru Seva, not that half an hour I can beg from Mayadevi, I can engage myself in Maya Seva, not that. Uninterrupted Seva, Guru Seva, Prabhupada speaking, surely they can get the realization of that aprakita tattva. Tattva-gyan they can get. Genuine tattva-gyan they can realize from heart. Genuine tattva-gyan, if they realize from heart, that means you are going to do non-stop seva. To realize tattva-gyan means to do non-stop seva of Bhagavan, Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. Prabhupada speaking, only they can get the chance to get entry into their aprakita seva and aprakita dham. Not everybody. Those who are getting tattva-gyan in this life, not that after this life gone and next life you can take birth, not that. Surely, this life, this life you can get tattva-gyan, and realization of your tattva-gyan can engage you in continuous guru-seva, bhagavat-seva, dham-nam-seva, and surely you are going to get nitya, you know, seva in nitya dham. That is the procedure. So Jiva Goswami Pada from Varanasi, Kashi Varanasi, going to Vrindavan, and all the time staying there up to his last moment of his life, he was staying in Vrindavan. That is called Dham Ashray. Ashray means, if I give one example you can understand properly. Suppose suddenly in the night time there is big flood coming. Big flood going to, you know, everybody and every house and, you know, items, you know, going, flowing and going. You are also flowing, and your child gone somewhere, your husband gone, you gone somewhere. Try to feel this point. It's practical experience. In Murshidabad, night time, they are sleeping 2000 years, you know. There, that time, there was a big, you know, flat. That time, night time, they are sleeping, suddenly, blood coming, everybody going to die. Mother going this way, child going this way, so husband going to die this way. Who can protect whom? In this condition, if you can realize this point, then Never you can feel sorry for the situation you are facing in your life. But you should think the current of Maya, you are flowing, you know, material life. Anything can happen anytime. Tsunami, earthquake, tsunami, anytime, anything, flood, earthquake, so many problems can happen. So life has got no certainty. There's no certainty of life. So you are actually alone. Alone means Guru Vishnu Bhagavan is there with you. Nobody else. Nobody else. Nobody else. Only Guru Vishnu Bhagavan, you can take shelter of them. Otherwise, if you are going to take shelter of your bank money, if you are going to take shelter of your husband, going to take shelter of your son, all useless. Only and only you will have to take shelter onto a lotus feet of pure Guru Vishnu, Bhagavan, Dham, Nam, they can protect you. All life, uncertain life, and instability. So anyway, if you can feel this point, if you can feel this point directly, what a, you know, painful situation. Suddenly night 10 flood coming, all, you know, everybody going to die, and mother going, you know, father going this way, and small child going this way, oh. Suddenly, if you can, if you are flowing in, you know, current, water current, suppose you are going to meet with a branches of tree there, banyan tree, then you can suddenly catch that banyan tree. Somehow, weak current flow, but still you are not going to leap. Somehow you are going to catch, and somehow you are going to climb that tree, and you are, you know, crying. Somehow your life is saved. You are going to catch that branches or some roots are there, you know, because banyan trees, their main root is there, down, and sometimes from up, different, you know, the trees, ultimately going to, from there also roots coming and going down. And so that time, your life is somehow saved. This is the situation, if you can, so now you are going to take shelter of that banyan tree. That is also not perfect example. Suppose there is infighting between two countries, and from one country some people, they are taking shelter here in these countries and other countries. After the war is over, they can go back again. That is not called shelter. You know, that is not called shelter. Shelter means up to your last moment of life, you are not going to, anyhow, you are not going to leave that shelter. That is called Asraya Loiya Bhaje Tare Krishna. Anyhow, not that situation changing, weather changing, you know, environment changing, you are going to change your, you know, track. It's not called, it's called, you are not going to change. If you are not going to change, that is called Asraya. Now, actually, Jiva Goswami Pad going to take shelter of Rupa Sanatan. We can speak clearly that up to the last moment of Jiva Goswami Pad, never Jiva Goswami Pad going to leave the shelter. From then onward, going to stay with them. Only one time, from Dilli Vatsa, king from Delhi, requested Jiva Goswami Pad very, you know, strongly, you know, from heart, please you come. In Delhi, we like to find some solution over this contradiction. What is the contradiction? That is Ganga, position of Ganga is more high than Jamuna, or the position of Jamuna is more high, higher than Ganga. So Jiva Goswami Pad ultimately will agree to go, but with this condition, after that this assembly is over, he can come back very quickly. Very quickly. After the sabha is over, very quickly he can come back. So he is going there by very, very super fast, you know, horse, you know, car, and then after that coming back. Only one time. And there, Jiva Goswami Pad, Jiva Goswami Pad with full, you know, description, full evidence wanted to prove that Ganga is glory, you know, Ganga is very high, no problem. Ganga is really, because Ganga coming out from the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, position of Ganga is no doubt very high. But still, Ganga is also Shakti, Bhagavat Shakti. But Jamuna is Patrani. Jamuna is taking, you know, getting seva in Vrindavan all the time, all the time. You know, that's why Jamuna is actually Patrani, that's why the position of Ganga is more higher than Jamuna. Is more, the position of Jamuna is more higher than Ganga. They only one time Jiva Goswami went. Only one time in his life. After that, whole day, because he was the disciple of, he is the topmost Rupanuga. Material people, they are fighting over some issues. They want to prove that Jiva Goswami Pad not going to follow, Jiva Goswami Pad not at all going to follow Rupa Goswami Pad and Sanatan. They want to prove this way. Because Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to establish so many Siddhantas, Parakhiya Bhav, in such a way, so that common people, those who are foolish, they have no scope to misunderstand him. That's why. But actually, whole life, Jiva Goswami Pad staying under the guidance of Rupa Goswami, he is the topmost Rupanuga. Topmost Rupanuga. So he is doing service there all the time. He is giving service to Rupa Goswami Pad, because he took Diksha from Rupa Goswami Pad. Took Diksha, shelter. So they are serving all the time. When Rupa Goswami Pad writing books, when Rupa Goswami Pad writing books, then Jiva Goswami Pad playing handpan. You know. When there is no water, Jiva Goswami Pad going to Jamuna to bring water, drinking water for seva, this just all the time, doing seva with Rupa Goswami staying under the guidance of Rupa Goswami Pad. So, Jiva Goswami Pad, somebody speaking that Jiva Goswami Pad not following Rupa Goswami Pad or Sanatan. Because Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatan Goswami Pad, they are, you know, very, very humble, and Jiva Goswami Pad is not so humble. They want to prove this way. Also, they want to prove that Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya is not humble. Because Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya was bound to speak there that I am giving so much evidence, so much argument, still somebody not going to understand, not going to obey, then I am going to kick on his head. Tabelathi maruta sire rupore. So common people, they are going to speak, he has no trinadavi, he is not Vaishnava, there is no humble attitude, because he is going to speak this way. But they don't understand, he is Vyasadev, Chaitanya Vyasadev himself. So Vyasadev giving so much argument, after that if somebody not going to obey at all, then Vyasadev, Vrindavan Das Thakur, want to kick on his head, I mean, we want to apply his dust particle from his lotus feet on their head to rectify their brain so that they can understand. You can remember the sloka by Prahlad Maharaj. Motir na kishne parato shatova mitho vipaddet griho vratanam adant govir vishatam tamisram punaha puno charvito charvananam Motirna Kishne Paratoshatova. You know. Motirna Javat Mai Vasudevi. So many slokas there. So Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya only wanted to show exclusive kipa on them by applying, you know, this formula of kicking on their head. This way, but common people, they don't understand. I can give another example here in the life of Jiva Goswami Pad. Srila Vallabhacharya, Srila Vallabhacharya meeting Mahaprabhu 2-3 times, especially 2 times I know for sure, One is there in Adail Gram, in Allahabad, that side of Ganga, Adail Gram. When Mahaprabhu went in his house by his request, and Rupa Goswami Pad was there at that time with Mahaprabhu. So there, and after that, Vallabhacharya came here in Purushottam Dham to meet Mahaprabhu there also. And so, this way, that Vallabhacharya actually having some good relation, not only good relation, Vallabhacharya took Diksha from Gadadhar Pandit. From Gadadhar Pandit, he took Diksha, Kishore Gopal Mantra. Took Diksha, and he was there for some days. For some time, he was in Purushottam Dham. So, this way, he has some relationship with everybody. So, Vallabhacharya, one day, he was in Vrindavan, and he went to take bath in Ganga and in Jamuna. In the way, he met Rupa Goswami Pad near Seva Kunj, you know. Rupa Goswami Pad used to do bhajan there. And he find that Rupa Goswami writing some books. And Jiva Goswami, a small, you know, young man, going to play hand fan. Vallabhacharya asking, what book you are writing? Rupa Goswami was speaking, actually, it is Rasamrita Sindhu. I am writing, so compiling different evidence from different shastra, so that pure devotion, I am trying my best. Then, Vallabhacharya told him, okay, I can check up this book, I can edit this book, you can give to me. Rupa Goswami was very okay, very good. After that, Vallabhacharya gone to Jamuna, going towards Jamuna to take birth. Jiva Goswami Pad in the meantime took permission from Gurudev. Gurudev, there is no water, I like to take water from Jamuna. Okay, you go. In the meantime, he is following that Vallabhacharya. And when he is going to follow Vallabhacharya, you know, at the bank of Jamuna, he is asking to Vallabhacharya with humble attitude, not aggressive attitude. That what problem, what defects you have seen in the writing of my Gurudev, so that you told him that you can rectify. What do you mean? Is there any defects you have seen, a mistake there in the writing of my Guru Padma, so that you want to rectify? Then Vallabhacharya gone mad. Who is this boy? After that, gradually, they started discussion with each other. The Vallabhacharya within very shortly could realize is a great Pandit. Great Pandit, unparalleled, unbeaten. We like to speak that Jiva Goswami Pad is topmost Pandit in the whole world. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak that Jiva Goswami Pad and, you know, Jiva Goswami Pad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, we can compare Jiva Goswami Pad with Ramanujacharya, even more than that. So fine intellect, so Siddhanta Vichar. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur told this way. So Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to establish Siddhanta. He never wanted to insult him. He wanted to, what mistake you have seen in the writing of my Guru Padma, so you saw that you told him that you can rectify. Then after that discussion took place, then Vallabhacharya was a little bit upset. Vallabhacharya couldn't realize there can be such a boy who is so super intellect, high, big Pandit. After that, after taking bath in Jamuna, while going back, Again, Vallabhatto entering the Bhajan Kutir of Rupa Goswami Pada asking, excuse me, if you never mind, who is that boy? Who is that boy who is staying with you and doing seva? With humble attitude, Rupa Goswami Pada, what to speak? Actually, he is the son of my younger brother who already died as Anupam, his name was, and his name is Jiva. Really? After that, Vallabhatto gone. And Jiva Goswami Pada coming back with water, keeping water and started seva, but Rupa Goswami Pada calling him, come here! What happened, Gurudev? Then Rupa Goswami Pada started speaking in very heavily. In small age, in immature stage you have, taken this, renounced order. In a very immature state. So you should go back. I cannot see your face at all. Rupa Goswami Pada speaking this way, Jiva Goswami Pada started crying, what to do? But nobody can violate the instruction of Rupa Goswami Pada. Rupa Goswami Pada, you can go back. You have taken renunciation in a very small age, immature states. That's why this kind of problem happening. What problem in it? You couldn't bear? Vallabhatto come to me. He is full of mercy. Out of his mercy, causeless mercy, wanted to help me to edit that book. So you cannot be at this point. Eh? Go away from me. I don't like to see your face. Then Jiva Goswami Pada crying and going away from that place. And going up to, Baigaon. One place is there, one village is there, this is called Baigaon. Baigaon means fear. The place when Nanda Baba was abducted by the members of those, Barun. There's the servants of Barun. He was abducted. Nanda Maharaj, Baigaon. It is called Baigaon. So, Jiva Goswami Pada going away without any water, without nothing, ultimately going up to Baigaon. There, the Brajavasis, they develop very strong affection for him. They requested you, please stay here for some days. And Brajavasis, they are watching, is totally detachment. Even no care about water, prasadam, milk, nothing. By the request of Brajavasis, somehow, Jiva Goswami Pada going to keep his life, somehow. And day and night staying there, thinking the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma, Rupa Goswami Pada, Sarva Sangbadini, he compiled there, and also he get information, clue, we have indication, that Shato Sandarbha, six Sandarbha, Jiva Goswami Pada, he compiled all six Sandarbha there, while staying there in Baigaon. There he was, compiling this, Shato Sandarbha, Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if somebody can understand Shato Sandarbha is a jewel. Shato Sandarbha is a jewel, unparalleled, unbeaten. So precious jewel, we cannot compare with anybody, anything. So, Shato Sandarbha is a precious jewel in Gaudiya's bhajan life. So, after compiling this, in the meantime, Sanatana Goswami, he was habituated to travel around different villages of Vrindavan. He was habituated. Different villages, different time. Writing, moving here, there, this way. So, That time, Sanatana Goswami got information from Brajavasis, some very nice, you know, so handsome, you know, one Baba coming there in our village. Oh, really? He is not taking properly your prasadam, water, nothing. Oh, really? Where? Oh, then after that, Sanatana Goswami could realize who that Baba can be. After that, fine. Jiva Goswami Pada. Jiva is there. And in front of Sanatan, Jiva Goswami Pada started crying and bursted into tears heavily, crying and crying, not stopping. After that, ultimately, Jiva Goswami said, What happened? Sanatan Goswami asking. After that, he was bound to speak all in details what all happened. So Sanatan Goswami Pada then took responsibility to take Jiva Goswami Pada in front of Gurudev, I mean Rupapad, took responsibility. So then Jiva Goswami Pada following Sanatana Goswami Pada, coming there, standing in some place, because who can say if my Gurudev can again throw me out, who can say? After that, Sanatana Goswami Pada is going to meet Rupa Goswami Pada. Rupa Goswami Pada paying dandavat, everything, mutual respect. After that, Sanatana Goswami Pada was speaking very heavily that Jive Daya, this word we can find only in philosophy, in book. Rupa Goswami Pada asking, what do you mean? Now, I mean to say that Jiva Daya, this word we can find in books, not in application. After that, Sanatan calling Jiva Goswami Pada, then Rupa Goswami Pada could realize, and he was, you know, bound to accept Jiva Pada again. Actually, Rupa Goswami Pada not going to throw him out. This is one kind of teachings. Is one kind of teaching, actually. So, Jiva Goswami Pada has done no mistake. There was no mistake on the part of Jiva Goswami Pada. Because Jiva Goswami Pada wanted to establish the full dignity and full glories of Guru Pada Padma. If somebody going to dishonor my Guru Pada Padma, it is Siddhanta. That I will have to establish Siddhanta. I have to establish the glories of Guru Pada Padma. So Jiva Goswami Pada has done nothing wrong, but still it was one kind of teachings given by Rupa Goswami Pada. From them onward, actually. Not only that, but also Srila Sanatana Goswami Pada and Srila Rupa Goswami Pada, they used to write so many books. And they always used to give their books for editing to Jiva Goswami Pada. Always. So many books they are compiling, so they are writing. After that, Brihat Bhagavatam Mito, Rasamrita Sindhu, whatever book they are writing, going to hand over to Jiva Pada. Now you think the relationship. Going to hand over to Jiva Pada for final touch. Final touch they used to give. Is there no mistake on the part of Jiva Goswami Pada, but still it was one kind of teachings given. Another day I can remember, actually some Digvijay Pandit, he demanded, is a great Pandit. He is going everywhere, Digvijay Pandit, you know, like Mahaprabhu meet with Digvijay Pandit, Keshav Kashmiri. Ultimately he was bound to throw his all false ego, everything. And he was Acharya in his Sampradaya, Keshav Kashmiri, he. So he was also a Digvijay Pandit. Mahaprabhu broke his, you know, false ego, everything. Here also some Pandit, Digvijay Pandit, coming in Vrindavan and taking certificate from big Acharyas. You give me certificate that you are defeated. All big, big acharya going to give their certificate to him, okay, I am defeated. Even Rup Sanatan, they are also in front of them, they are coming. If you like to discuss, you know, spiritual discourse can take place. Otherwise, if you are less interested, then you can give certificate to me. Then Rup Sanatan giving certificate without any fighting, without any comment. Rup Sanatan going to give certificate to him that we are defeated, you are actually enjoying victory. So you can go. He is going away. And Jiva Goswami Pad came to know that our, you know, Gurudevs, Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatana Goswami, they are going to give certificate to him that they are defeated. Then Jiva Goswami Pad speaking to him that what? That you know my Guru Padmanabha Rupa Goswami Pad. So you are going to collect, you know, certificate from him that they are defeated, they are going to declare. Eh? If you can defeat me, you sit in front of me, please. You sit in front of me, please. And if you can defeat me, then after that you can get the certificate. Otherwise, I am going to tear up the certificate. You have no right to take this certificate from my Guru Bhattva. Then actually, scriptural discussion took place within short period. That Digvijaya Pandit could realize it is quite impossible to defeat Jiva Goswami Pad. Quite impossible. Nobody there in the whole world. In the whole world, nobody there who can defeat Jiva Goswami Pad. Impossible. After that, he was bound to give back the certificate. So this is one kind of Siddhanta. This is Trinadapi. If you think that Jiva Goswami Pad speaking this way, going to defeat that Pandit, wanted to protect the glories of Guru Bhargava, it is not Trinadapi, then you are foolish number one. It is Trinadapi. It is Trinadapi, it is Siddhanta. If you cannot do it, if you cannot give full protection to Siddhanta Bani, or if you cannot protect the glories of Guru Bhargava, and you are going to speak, and I am humbler than a blade of grass, it is useless. It is false, kapat. This is not Trinadapi. To protect the glories of Guru Vaishnava, to give full protection to Siddhanta Bani, if I need to speak very heavily, that is also Trinadapi. Bhaktivinoda Thakur already told, I told you that day. Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, that if we are going to establish our Siddhanta Vijaya, everything, give full protection to Siddhanta Bani, in course of doing this seva, if we are going to develop some fighting with somebody, those who are Mayavadis, in the guise of Vaishnava, Acharya, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if I am going to do this seva, to give full protection to Siddhanta Bani, very, in that case, if I develop some kind of fighting, you know, trouble, still, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, we should bear it for the sake of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. For the seva of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, for the seva of Chaitanya Vani, for the perfect seva of Chaitanya Vani, if I am going to develop some bitter relation with you, with somebody, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is good. Because you are doing for the service of Gauranga, not for your own sake. This way actually, Jiva Goswami Pad, going to show Trinada Vibhav. But foolish people, they don't understand. When Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking this way, Purisher Kitoite Muishe Logishto, Jagai Madai Hoiche Muishe, Papishto, Purisher Kitoite Muishe Logishto, then common people say, it's Trinadapi. It is called Trinadapi. Actually, Vrindavan Das Thakur Maharaj are not Trinadapi, and Jiva Goswami Pad not. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, foolish people, they don't understand Siddhanta Vichar. They don't understand Siddhanta Vichar. topmost Acharya, Siddhanta Acharya, Vedanti, topmost Gaudiya Vedantist. Gaudiya Vedanti, you know, in our line, is Jiva Goswami Pad. His Siddhanta, Sato Sandarbha, everything, written so many Brahma Sangita, Tika, you know, so many books, you know, written by him, even Vyakaran. Jiva Goswami Pad was so merciful. Jiva Goswami Pad was thinking long time, who can memorize Panini Vyakaran? Panini Vyakaran is a vast chapter. For the past 18 years, somebody reading Panini Vyakaran still cannot have any controlling. So vast chapter, you know. So Jiva Goswami Pad was so merciful that he took trouble to collect all dhatu, roots, everything, dhatu, everything, everything. He wanted to collect everything in Vyakaran and wanted to formalize, put formula, so that those who are going to read Vyakaran, they need not waste their time. They can, when they are going to memorize Vyakaran Sutra, they can memorize, you know, Vyakaran Sutra, but without any maya. Because Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to relate it with Brahman, mane all different names, Vishnu, Brahman, Gadadha, all different, you know, Bhagavan Nam, he wanted to relate total Vyakaran Sutra. Total Vyakaran Sutra, Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to relate with the name of Supreme Lord, somehow quite impossible. If you have any common sense, if you go through Harinamita Vyakaran, then you can realize how it is possible to relate all sutra formula, you know, like to relate with Supreme Lord. How possible? Impossible. So nicely he was bound to formulate all Vyakaran in relation to Vishnunam, Krishnunam, you know, oh, impossible. This way actually, Jiva Goswami Pad was bound and Rupa, and our Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if somebody can realize Sato Sandarbha, he can get clear idea on Vedanta Sutra. To understand Vedanta Sutta clearly, if you go through Sato Sandarbha under the guidance of a big Pandit, I mean Bhakta, then you can come out successful. You can understand all the inner meaning of Vedanta. All different secret Tattva Vedanta, illustrated there in Srimad Bhagavad-ji Mahapuran, and from there, Jiva Goswami Pad was bound to compile all Sato Sandarbha so that there cannot be any problem, any contradiction, any doubt about any Siddhanta, nothing. Jiva Goswami Pad, Sutestu Sabda Mulatvat, Jiva Goswami Pad always wanted to give value to Sabda Praman. Sabda Praman is topmost. All other Praman is there, but Sabda Praman is topmost. Sutesu Sabda Mulatvat. You know, this Vedanta Sutta can, you know, Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to explain very clearly that Sabda Praman is Anantaparam Kila Sadva Sastram, you know, but out of that, Jiva Goswami Pad always wanted to establish Achintya Vedavettatta. Because if you cannot understand Achintya Vedavettatta, you cannot understand anything. Comparative statement of four different sampradaya, I already done before, but someday I like to again discuss the four sampradaya, four pillars of Vaishnav Darshan. And out of them, men, you know, like, you know, Shankaracharya Kevaladvaitavad, Bhaskaracharya Upadhik Bhed Abhedvad, Ramanujacharya Vishishtadvaitavad, you know, Nimbarkacharya Bhedabhedvad, Madhacharya Madhacharya actually Dvaitadvaitavad, and Vishnu Swami Shuddhadvaitavad. All different characters, if you cannot understand their respective views, then you can never understand what is Achintya Vedavet Tattva. If you can understand all respective, you know, four different darshans, four, five actually, including Shankaracharya. Shankaracharya, Mayava, actually Siddhanta, Kevaladvaitavad. So, Vishnu Swami Shuddhadvaitavad and Madhvacharya Dvaitadvaitavad. Ramanujacharya Vishishtadvaitavad, all Shakti Siddhanta there. So I can try to discuss this someday, but time today cannot allow. So, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always wanted to give this Achintya Vedavet Tattva in front of us. And Achintya Vedavet Tattva, if you like to understand properly, you'll have to understand four to understand Achintya Vedavet Tattva properly, you'll have to take information about the four different pillars on which this Achintya Vedavet Tattva is resting very with all proper adjustment. Four pillars mean four acharyas, Ramanucharya, Madhvacharya, Vishnu Swami, Nimbarka, they are four pillars. Like we say, na, we are saying na that Madhvacharya is the main pillar. Hey, Madhvacharya, you know, Madhavendu Puripad is the, and previous acharya is Madhvacharya, main pillar of Saraswati Gaudiya Sampradaya. Madhavendu Puripad. So on the basis of the Siddhanta Achintya Vedavet, Mahaprabhu already wanted to establish, Jiva Goswami Pada always wanted to give the Siddhanta Achintya Vedavet Tattva in front of us. And also I like to speak that Jiva Goswami Pada as such was less interested to give Diksha to everybody, very selected. But we know that Narottama Thakur, Srinivas Acharya, Samananda Prabhu, all they came to take Shiksha from Srila Jiva Goswami Pada. Actually, Srinivas Acharya, he took Diksha from Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Follow, Samananda Prabhu took Diksha from, you know, Gauridas Pandi, his sister is, you know, I forget his name. And he took Diksha from him. Hidayi Chaitanya. He took Diksha. This way, Samananda Prabhu took Diksha from there. Also, Narottama Thakur took Diksha from Loknath Goswami. But be sure, all of them took permission from their respective Guru Charan, like Gopal Bhatta Goswami giving full permission to Srinivas Acharya to take Shiksha from Jiva Goswami Pada. This way Narottama Thakur also getting chance. You know, Samananda Prabhu also get it. This way, they are taking, you know, Diksha, full, all the time. After that, Jiva Goswami Pada giving them responsibility to take all Gaudiya Siddhanta books written by Rupa Sanatana, everything, and also Jiva Goswami Pada writing so many things, Madhava Utsavadi, so many books writing. So after that, Jiva Goswami Pad giving responsibility to them, I mean to Srinivasajyo and Narottama Thakur and you know Samananda Prabhu to go to Bangla and preach this Siddhanta Vichara everywhere. Everywhere. There actually they started for Bengal. You know, I am not going to speak in details because I have no time. In the way in Bankura district, and there all books and everything was taken away, stolen by one dacoit. One dacoit actually. Stolen. I can speak in details on the Avirbhav Tithi of Srinivasacharya, not Birhambir Raja. Who Birhambir Raja ultimately took Diksha from Srinivasacharya. So powerful. Srinivasacharya. I can touch one point so that you can understand their power, you know. After all books stolen, Srinivasacharya gone mad, he is crying. And depending upon the mercy of Gauranga, it must be some planning of Supreme Lord. It must be some arrangement of Supreme Lord. It cannot so happen that Vaishnava giving, there cannot be any danger. In the meantime, he got clue that this Birhambir Raja, this king, is, you know, daytime he is acting as king, he is hearing Bhagavatam, everything, and night time he is doing dakat. He is actually dacoit. Night time, he is going to, you know, take away everything. But anyway, he is not going to put these people, those who are staying in his kingdom, and not going to put them in trouble. Very friendly with them. Birhambir Raja. So now Srinivasacharya took the opportunity to go there. In the assembly of Bhagavad Sabha, Srinivasacharya hearing Harikatha there, and somebody going to explain in Vyasasan. And in Vyasasan, he is going to explain Rasa Leela in a very dirty way. Srinivasacharya was very, very offended, very, very angry. Srinivasacharya was bound to protest. This way you are going to explain Rasa Leela? Eh? You think Rasa Leela is material thing? Then King Birhambir, he also took the opportunity. He told, well, you can explain. Well, you can explain. You can explain Rasa Leela and Bhagavad-Gita from tomorrow. Then Srinivasacharya sitting in Vyasasan and started explaining Krishna Leela in such a way, sweet. Then everybody started crying. All, everybody, even Birhambir Raja gone mad. After that, Birhambir Raja fall down on his lotus feet, praying prostrated dando and begging for pardon, and saying, you can please, you know, give me Diksha. Mutual understanding was there. So Srinivasacharya got back all his lost treasure, Gaudiya Siddhanta books, all he got back, and Birhambir Raja, he took Diksha in Madan Mohan Mandir there. I've been there long ago, maybe 10 years back. I've been there in Bankura. There I saw the place, Birhambir. And the Bhagavat speaker, previously who was speaking Bhagavatam, and Srinivasacharya protest, that man also took shelter onto the lotus feet of Srinivasacharya. This was so powerful. So Radhes, that place, preaching was done by Srinivasacharya, extensive way, massive way. Even grandson of that Birhambir Raja. At the time of Birhambir Raja, massive preaching of Gaudiya philosophy, Gaudiya darshan, Gauranga Mahaprabhu's siksha teachings was done. After that, grandson was also very nice. Grandson, he was, you know, his name was Gopal. He was so powerful that in his kingdom he gave instruction to everybody. Well, everybody must take Harinam. If I get information that somebody not taking Harinam, then I can give severe punishment to him. From then, all the people staying in his kingdom, that Gopal Singho, his name was Gopal Singho. Hana. So, from our grandfather, grandmother, we heard one thing, that is, Gopal Singh is beggar. Beggar means, without any reason, I am going to give some energy for Harinam. Because they are not developing Harinam, in attraction for Harinam, they are speaking. So everybody must do Harinam. Without Harinam, if getting information, Gopal Singh, his name was. This way, extensive preaching was done. Narottama Thakur gone to, you know, extreme west, extreme east, Manipur, Tripura, there, and Orissa and in Medinipur, etc. This place, Samananda Prabhu. This way, extensive preaching was done. What to speak? Massive preaching was done. They all took diksha from Jiva Goswami Pad, from her. When Rupa Sanatan gone, then Jiva Goswami Pad was the topmost authority. Because all gone, gradually all gone, na. Rupa Sanatan, previous is Sarva Gosai gone, Raghunath, all, you know, Raghunath Das Gosai after some days gone, because Jiva Goswami Pad was there, and Raghunath Goswami always, you know, praying unto the lotus feet of Jiva Goswami Pad. You think, Raghunath Das Gosai always praying unto the lotus feet of Jiva Goswami Pad to get kipa. So you can remember. So, though Raghunath Das Gosai also topmost Rupanuga candidate, and Jiva Goswami Pad also still this way. I can give one incident. One day, Jiva Goswami Pad sitting all around, they are sitting to take, you know, hear Harikatha, getting Siddhanta Vichar from Jiva Goswami Pad. One day, Jiva Goswami Pad asking, I am going to put some question in front of you, you will have to give me answer. What is that question? So many questions, Jiva Goswami Pad putting question in front of them. They are giving answer. One question is very typical question. Jiva Goswami Pad speaking. Now there is one typical question, you will have to give answer. What is that? But this Kadamba Bhiksha, this Kadamba tree, all you know, after Krishna gone, all trees and keepers, they are feeling separation. They are almost going to dry. They are almost going to dry. So painful situation. But this Kadamba tree, why is so full of leaf and flower, this, that, so glamorous? Why? they are thinking, by the mercy of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Srinivas Acharya, because Srinivas Acharya is the incarnation of Gauranga. Samananda Prabhu is the incarnation of Advaita Gosai. And Narottama Thakur is the incarnation of our Nityananda Prabhu. So, Srinivas Acharya speaking, Prabhu, if you never mind, I like to give answer. Well, you can speak. What happens? Then Srinivas Acharya speaking, Prabhu, all trees and keepers, they are feeling pain of separation, they are, you know, drying off. But this Kadamba Bhiksha, it was planted by Krishna himself before going to Mathura. Oh, really? Yes. This Kadamba Bhiksha was planted by Krishna himself before going to Mathura. So after going to Mathura, Krishna always giving mental support, mental blessing to that, you know, Kadamba Bhiksha, mentally giving nourishment. Mentally, Krishna giving nourishment to this Kadamba Bhiksha. So this Kadamba Bhiksha getting mental association of Krishna. That's why this Kadamba Bhiksha is not feeling problem. Same question was put in front of, you know, some devotees, that why Jamuna Nodi not feeling so bad, whereas everybody feeling. Those Gopikas, they are asking, you know, Jamuna always getting mental nourishment of Krishna all the time. All the time is getting the association of Krishna and, you know, Radharani. That's why she is always cheerful. This question coming in the glorification of Srimad Bhagavatam, which you can find in Skanda Puran, not Padma Puran. Padma Puran, Gokarna Upakhyan, and Skanda Puran you can get this glorification. Why? Does Gopika ask you, why you, we are so, we all break down, we are going to cry, we cannot, you know, bear. Why you are feeling? That's why. This kind of answer we can get from them. Now, Jiva Goswami Pad used to organize, used to give leadership to everybody. Even in Vrindavan, in Brajamandal, Jiva Goswami Pad had full authority. Everybody going to obey him. Vishwa Vaishnava Rasabha, if somebody going to give wrong Siddhanta, his character loose, making problem in the field of bhajan, it was the usual rule. And that all Vaishnava society, they can call him, why you are going to contaminate our society system, you know, this parampara. Why? This way, all the time, they always taking control over who is doing what, where, in Bengal, Orisha, in everywhere, in Vrindavan, who is doing what, they are having, they, Jiva Goswami Pada wanted to give full harmony to them up to that point. Big authority, Jiva Goswami Pada. Also, Jiva Goswami Pada used to do Brajamandal Parikrama time to time. It was the rule. Actually, Sanatana Goswami Pada all the time going here and there in Vrindavan. So, Jiva Goswami Pada also used to go here and there in Brajamandal Parikrama, especially when Sinadji Gopal, Gopalji Maharaj, when Gopalji Maharaj at the time of Mahaprabhu, you know, Gopalji Maharaj came down. You can go through Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can find Mahaprabhu wanted to take darshan of Gopal Dev. But Mahaprabhu never wanted to touch Giriraj by leg. Because Giriraj is Krishna himself. Giriraj is Krishna himself. Mahaprabhu speaking, Giriraj Sila is the body of Krishna. So anyway, when Mahaprabhu wanted to take darshan of Sinadji Maharaj, then Sinadji Maharaj coming down in Gathuli Gram. Gathuli, I've been there. Gathuli Gram, one village there. There the Brajavasis took Gopal to give full protection from Muslim attack. It is not Anur. From Anur you will have to go enter. More inner side, not Parikrama Marg. I've been there, Gathuli Gram. There in Brajavasi's room, there they liked wanted to give full protection to Gopalji Maharaj, Sinaji Gopal. After that, Gopalji Maharaj was taken into the house of Bittalnath. Bittalnath is the son of Ballabhacharya. Ballabhata, you know, is the son of Ballabhacharya. But in the month of Kartik Chaturmas, actually, Balla Bhatta Atmaja Vitthaleshwar Bhavane, in their house, Gopal was there. Responsibility was given because they were already Gauriya Sampradaya. After that, in his parampara, after two parampara gone, then grandson, he wanted to make a new parampara. Previously, there was no problem. But after that, they started new parampara. This is called Ballabhi Sampradaya. They don't know who is Ballabh. They don't know. His name is Ballabh. I mean, Vitthaleshwar, his son. So, Vitthaleshwar, in his house in Mathura, Jiva Goswami Pada, Jiva Goswami Pada, all devotees, they used to go to take darshan of Gopal Dev, Gopalji Maharaj, all devotees. Jiva Goswami used to go there to take darshan of Gopalji Maharaj in Mathura Dham. In the time of, you know, Jiva Goswami Pad, when Jiva Goswami Pad, by the leadership, by the acharyaship of Jiva Goswami Pad, in Radha Kundo, Gopinath Jiu Mandir, Radha Gopinath, but Jannava Devi, who is Ananga Manjuri, Jannava Devi is Ananga Manjuri, his deity was also installed by the desire of Jiva Goswami Pad, right appropriate Siddhanta. Jannava Devi is actually Ananga Manjuri. So by the desire of, you know, Jiva Goswami Pad, this deity was installed there. And by that time, we already know, there in Kalna, the deity of Gaur Nityananda was installed. After that, when Gauranga Mahaprabhu gone away, then Vishnu Biha Devi installed, Dameshwar, Gaur. This way, all the deities of Gauranga Nityananda, you know, appearing different place to give opportunity to give seva to us. You know, so this, you know, Jiva Goswami Pad, from Jiva Goswami Pad, Srinivas Acharya got this title Acharya. This Acharya title, Srinivas Acharya, Srinivas Ji Maharaj got from Jiva Goswami Pad. Thakur Mahasaya, Narottama Thakur, this title also was given by Jiva Goswami Pad. You know, this way actually all titles were given to them. So, also, it was the responsibility of Jiva Goswami Pad, any new man coming, any new devotee from Gaurdham coming, it was the responsibility of Srila Jiva Goswami Pad to arrange prasadam and where they can take rest, everything, all. Total, full authority. Now actually, we are really bad luck. How, you know, other sampradaya can speak something against us? So influential, so powerful our sampradaya is, but we are going to lose all our power day by day because of our own character, own, you know, loose character, everything. We are losing day by day. So, already I told there's different acharyas, four acharyas. Four acharyas, they wanted to explain their own darshan. They have their respective darshan. They wanted to explain their darshan on the basis of that Vedanta Sutra. Brahma Sutra is the basic platform. Brahma Sutra is the basic platform on the basis of which all those four acharyas, even after that so many acharyas came, they wanted to give total explanation from different angle of view. But basically, they all believe that Bhagavan Supreme Lord and devotee, their eternal relationship, they believe bhakti, they believe. So basically, they are all bhakti acharya. Ultimately, in Gaudiya Sampradaya, especially in Gaudiya Sampradaya, there was no Vedanta. Especially in Gaudiya Sampradaya, there was no commentary of Vedanta because we believe that Madhvacharya's Vedanta explanation is okay, no problem, we need not, you know. Right, because those Goswamis, Jiva Goswami Pad, Rupa Goswami Sonata, they were so powerful, they could easily compile. But they didn't think it necessary because Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran is the natural, you know, in interpretation. It is a commentary, we are naturally getting commentary of Vedanta Sutra through Bhagavatam. We know from Gayatri Sutra Ayam, Artho Ayam, Artho Ayam, you know, this sloka from Garuda Purana, Vedanta, Vedanta Sutta, Artho, everything we can get total explanation from Bhagavatam. That's why they didn't think it necessary. But when argument took place there, that time Vishwanath Chakravarti was there, but he was very old age. Then Baladev Vidyabhushan was sent with Baladev Vidyabhushan, another devotee was there. Both of them were sent by Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Bhat, because originally Vishwanath Chakravarti Bhat was invited to find solution. Because Govindade Seva, who can get? They are not ready to give Seva to Gaudiya Sampradaya. They say, you have no commentary, you are not really authentic Sampradaya. Then after that problem took place, the king of Jaipur was in problem. He was bound to convey one big, you know, Dharma Sabha. They wanted to find solution. And here, Vishwanath Chakravarti was old age, very old age. So he was bound to send Baladev Vidyabhushan and another devotee to there in Jaipur to take part in the, you know, argument, you know, Hastiya Vichar. There Baladev Vidyabhushan was asked, the all other three sampradaya asking, we like to hear Vedanta Vichar from your Gaudiya Sampradaya. On the basis of which Vasya? On the basis of which Vasya you like to discuss? Then naturally Baladev Vidyabhushan told, well, I like to follow Madhvacharya Vasya. Then they putting argument, Madhvacharya Gopal is there is no Radharani. So how you can? Madhvacharya Gopal is there, but there is no Radharani. So how you can take, you know, the help of Madhvacharya? Then Baladev Vidyabhushan was in trouble. Oh my God. They don't understand with Gopalji, with everything is there, with Govindaji, everything there. Radharani there, they're not ready to confess. Then Baladev Vidyabhushan took permission, 7-10 days. Within that period, I can submit our Gaudiya Vedanta Vasya of Vedanta Sutra. Then actually, Baladev Vidyabhushan coming in front of Govindaji Maharaj, fasting without water and prasadam, always praying unto the lotus feet of Govindaji, please protect the honor of Gaudiya Sampradaya. Because you yourself came in the form of Gauranga. If we cannot give protection to Gauranga, it's very... So rich treasure of Bani Bhai. No, in the whole world, there is no comparison. No comparison. We cannot compare Gaudiya Sampradaya with any Sampradaya. Impossible. Nobody can fight. So exclusive, you know, place, Gaudiya Sampradaya. But we are going to lose everything. This way, actually, Baladev Vidyabhushan, within short period, you know, by the mercy of Govindaji, Govindaji went on speaking. It is called Govinda Vasya. Govindaji, in the night time, giving full, you know, Baladev Vidyabhushan writing. So, Baladev Vidyabhushan was bound to compile Vedanta Vasya, which is based on Achinta Vedavatta also. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, we have information from our previous Guru Varga, that Baladev Vidyabhushan is Gopinath Acharya. When Mahaprabhu wanted to give full discourse of Gaudiya Vedanta in front of Sarvamurti Acharya, that time Gopinath Acharya was there present, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it can be true. There is no doubt. Because Gopinath Acharya, he was there, he was hearing both, you know, both Mahaprabhu and Sarvamurti Acharya argument. After that, Gopinath Acharya, after leaving body means the eternal body, Parshat, you know, was still changing body and coming in the form of Baladev Vidyabhushan. Baladev Vidyabhushan, a topmost hero, jewel. Like I told na, Jiva Goswami Pad, such Vedanti in the whole world, nobody can find. So topmost Vedanti. Even Vallabhacharya ultimately was bound to confess that Jiva Goswami is top. He wrote one book, Tattva Pradeep. Tattva Deep, not Pradeep. Tattva Deep. Vallabhacharya, he compiled one book, is Tattva Pradeep. Tattva Deep, not Tattva Pradeep. After writing, he was bound to come in front of Jiva Goswami Pad and speaking, I have compiled this book. Would you please go through this book? Jiva Goswami Pad, okay, as you like. Then after going through this book, Jiva Goswami Pad was bound to, you know, indicate so many mistakes. Try to think, what a, you know, Jiva Goswami Pad was bound to point out some mistake, major mistake, Siddhanta. And Vallabhacharya was also bound to accept it without any argument. Well, what Siddhanta we are speaking is all. So according to the editing of Jiva Goswami Pad, Vallabhacharya, he was bound to publish that book. So you see, what a great Acharya Vallabhacharya, actually our Jiva Goswami Pad. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Baladev Vidyabhushan also a great jewel. In Samananda Parivar, in the way of Samananda Parivar, that's so long history, I don't like to discuss, no time cannot permit. So, if someday I can discuss about comparative statement of, again, because previously I already done, I can remember. Again, I like to discuss about comparative statement of five darshan from five angles. Shankaracharya, Madhvacharya, Nimbarkacharya, Vishnu Swami, Ramanujacharya, all. But Achintya Vedavetta Tattva is, you know, and on the basis of this fourth pillar, there is some very nice touch. There is a very nice touch given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know, very nice touch was given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his Achintya Vedavetta Tattva. From Ramanujacharya, Shakti Tattva given, Madhvacharya, actually Nitya Vigraha, Vishnu Swami, that, you know, Vishnu Swami, Nitya, Sevak, Seva, Sananda, all four different, you know, Siddhanta Vichar took from four Sampradaya, and Mahaprabhu was bound to give a very nice, you know, present us very nice Siddhanta Vijaya called Achintya Vedavetta Tattva. Achintya Vedavetta Tattva was given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Before that, there was so many complaint fighting. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is not new. Somebody can think that it is new, but it is not new. In Srimad Bhagavaji Mahapuran, Vyasadeva Goswami already wanted to indicate it. You can remember, I told Madhvacharya Abhirbhaptiti, Madhvacharya went to Vyasa Gufa in Bodhi Narayan there. And Vyasadeva Goswami was bound to come out of his bhajan kutir and embrace Madhvacharya. Madhvacharya getting full kripa of Vyasadeva. He is a disciple of Vyasadeva Goswami, actually. Krishna ito chaturmukhai Krishna sevanmukh. Brahma ite narade ramo hoti narado ite vyas muddha kahe vyasud. Purna pagga paddha nabamo hoti nihari madhava vangse akshava parame hangse shishavali angi karo kare. This is parampara. Madhvacharya, we can understand that Madhvacharya is the disciple of Vyasadeva Dhari. And when big fighting took place in Varanasi, because you know, Shankaracharya, you know, Shankaracharya, there is one kind of title. You know, there's big fighting took place. Then all those pure devotees, they could realize in the sky, there is a dark blue, there was a dark blue appearance of Vyasadeva Goswami. And speaking, this fighting, logical interpretation cannot stand. Because Madhvacharya, getting my kippa, he is taking, speaking, he is going to speak this Siddhanta, you know, is okay. This verse. So this way actually, Achintya Vedavet Bhat, we will have to discuss all in details, because the ghost there in our brain cannot understand. Until unless we understand this Achintya Vedavet Tattva, we cannot understand what Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, what is the eternal relation between Jiva, Bhagavan, everything. Mayavadi, they want to prove there is no other Tattva except, you know, that's why they are speaking. They are speaking their Tattva is, you know, Shankaracharya Kevala Dvaitavad. Keval Advaita Bhat. Advaita means Nadvaita, there is one and single Brahma. Eka Brahma even aparaha. Brahma, without Brahma. Even Shankaracharya was not at all, even Shankaracharya was not at all ready to accept Shakti Tattva. If Shankaracharya thinking, if I am going to accept Shakti Tattva separately, then I am going to confess dual Tattva. But I am going to establish, you know, this, you know, I want to establish this only, this Mayavad Tattva, no? Mayavad Vichar. I want to establish Kevaladvaitabad. But Kevaladvaitabad, I cannot prove Kevaladvaitabad if I am going to accept this Shakti Tattva. But Ramanujacharya speaking Shakti Tattva, what problem? And especially Mahaprabhu, under the guidance of Mahaprabhu, Jiva Goswami was speaking. Shakti, Shakti, Mator, Avedit, Vedanta, Sutta, speaking. Shakti and Shaktiman, there is one single Tattva. But Shankaracharya not at all ready to confess it. But Mahaprabhu giving example, like fire, there is one fire glowing, and the power of fire, you know, dahan shakti, the power of fire is there inside this, that fire. It is not separate. It is together with that fire glowing. So we cannot make it separate. Similarly, shakti tattva we must confess. Without shakti tattva, we cannot understand the shakti, shaktiman, no value. If we are going to cut out Shakti Tattva from Brahma Tattva, then Brahma become useless. Then Brahma Tattva become useless, because Shakti Tattva I take out, it's impossible. Shakti Shakti Matarate Aved. Also from Shastra we know, Achintaha Khalu Jebhavaha Na Twangs Tarke Na Jojayet. Prakritibhyo param yaccha tad achintasya lakshanam. We know the Siddhanta. Achintaha khulu je bhavaha na twangs tarkena jojaya. Any achinta inconceivable tattva, we cannot apply our logical interpretation here. Because it is inconceivable. And achinta doesn't mean people think. Achinta means common people cannot think out. Not that. Achinto means inconceivable, we cannot, even if we play our brain, it's impossible. That's why it is Achinto Vedavet, not that. Achinto Vedavet means it is quite impossible to understand. Even you apply your mind, everything, nothing. You know, all your efforts can come out failure. Achinto means, you know, you cannot bring it in your conception. You cannot bring it in your conception. Not possible. Chinta, tarko. So this way, you know, achinto means people think we cannot think. But we know so many things in this material world. We cannot give any argument. We have no argument. Why sugar is sweet? Why sugar is sweet? Is there any why nimphal fruits is bitter? Huh? Why this is sweet, this is pungent, this is we have no argument. We have no what we can speak. This way, how it is Mahaprabhu speaking, how it is possible that by the touch of touchstone, how it is possible that all metal can be changed into gold. Follow. Iron can be converted into gold. Iron can be converted into gold if it is in touch with, even our Shastra, so many arguments there. So many, not one argument. Some chemicals are there, in contact with chemical, if we put kangso means kasa, bell metal, and this, that, so many, in Shastra it is there. If we are going to keep it with this, rasayan, chemical, after some day we can find converted to gold. It is possible. And those scientists, they are also bound to confess it. Because if it is possible for touchstone to touch iron piece and convert the molecular structure of that iron, why not possible? Then it's possible. Gold molecular structure is different. Iron molecular structure is different. If that touchstone have that kind of exclusive power to convert this molecular structure, everything, and then it can be converted. It is 100% it can be possible. So many things are there. But at present, due to Kali, we don't like to believe it. Even Chandrakantamani, Chandrakantamani means moonstone. Chandrakantamani. If you can get original Chandrakantamani, original, ever genuine, 100%. In front of Chandrakantamani, that moonstone, you can find fire not going to show his own power. Fire, even fire get cold. You cannot believe. Due to Kali, they are all going to missing their power. Chandrakantamani. In front of Chandrakantamani, fire also cannot show his power. It is written in Shastra. I can show you so many. But due to Kali, day by day, Brahman cannot show that kind of power. Vaishnav cannot show that. Because due to Kali contamination, they are going to lose their power. But if we can follow clearly, very appropriately, properly, accurately, the track shown by Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, nobody can take away power from us. Be sure about that. So, achintaha khalu yevhavaha na tang starke na jojayet prakriti vyaha param jaccha tad achintasya lakshanam. That is called achinta lakshanam. Achinta lakshan doesn't mean only you cannot conceive. Achinta means there is another platform where you can find all solution out of your prema. Follow. We know from Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran first, Janma Adasu Yate Anvayadito Rascharta Savigya Sarad Sarat. You cannot make any compromise with Krishna. Not possible. Also, Brahma also speaking, Gane Prayasa Mudabhasana Mantiyava. This Brahma speaking. We cannot make any compromise with Krishna. Bhagavan is Ananta. We are teeny. We have no existence. So small. Infinitely small. So how we can make relationship with the Supreme Lord? This Achinta Vedavet Tattva, our Gosai Pad wanted to show the yes. No question of argument. Out of this Achinta Tattva, we can get another platform which is the platform of prema. This platform of prema, when Bhagavan bound to speak, when bound, aham bhakta pradhino, aham bhakta paradhino, hi asidanta ivadijo. Is there actually, Krishna is sarat. Nobody can get control over Krishna. But Krishna himself speaking, aham bhakta paradhino, hi asidanta ivadijo. Krishna speaking himself. So there is another platform which is called, which is the platform of prema. Achinto means not only that you cannot conceive. Achinto also means there is one such sweet platform. There is such a sweet platform on which if you can reach on that platform, that is the platform of prema, which is not at all possible, which is inconceivable, that is also possible. They are also possible out of prema. It's not possible, but also possible out of prema. That I can discuss someday. Because time cannot permit, Achintya Bhedabhed Tattva, you must understand so accurately, so accurately. Many Achintya Bhedabhed Tattva for 7 days we discussed clearly from different angles. And all different acharyas from 4 sampradayas, what they wanted to speak, what was the deficiency there in there, what Mahaprabhu wanted to compensate, wanted to make, you know, give a fine touch. They all wanted to make a nice picture of philosophy. But Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, was bound to give a final touch. So Achinto Bhedabhed Tattva not established by any bonded soul. Achinto Bhedabhed Tattva is not man-made. Achinto Bhedabhed Tattva is already there in Srimad Bhagavatam. Already there. Vyasadeva Goswami already giving indication. We are blind, we cannot see. Achivinda Vedabed Tattva is totally established by Sriman Mahaprabhu, but it is eternally present in eternal world. No question that it was not there, it was brought down by... No, not that. It was eternally present. Eternally it was present, simply Mahaprabhu wanted to point out. You know. So, if we cannot understand this Achinto Bhedabhed Tattva all the way, we are going to make mistake. We cannot get entry into Gaudiya Bhajan itself, Gaudiya Darshan. It's a great, you know, problem for us. Krishna kirtana gana nartana kalapatho jani vajita sadvakta valihamsa chakra madupo seni viharaspadam Karnanandi kaladhanir bahutume juha maru prangani si chaitanya dhanidheta balasad lila sudha sarduni vancha kalpataroshi ke basindu vachavati tanang pavana vaishnavyo namo. Actually tomorrow is the appearance day of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I consult one panjika which I have. They are so foolish, they are composing in such a way. When I look at the panjika, you know, casually, I see both same day. After that, carefully, no. There is no gapping. They maintain no gapping in the panjika. So I couldn't realize. So excuse me. And I beg for apology. So tomorrow is the Avirbhav Tithi.